Hi everybody, this is Annie from How's Annie. Welcome to part three of season two of Planet Earth. As you know, this is our little homage to Sarah Palmer because, you know, we feel pretty bad for her. She never asked to become whatever crazy thing she has become in the end. So yeah, today it's the jungle, so I think we're gonna see a lot of crazy animals. Also, in case you haven't received your Blu-ray set yet, or maybe even your DVD, well, I guess, you know, that will do for now. So, get your cigarette without a light, because who needs a light except for the woodsman? Nobody. Or people who wanna see in the dark, maybe. And your Bloody Mary as well. And we're gonna get started now. So hopefully it's gonna be an entertaining one. I have received this today. So it doesn't say do not distribute. It says do not disturb. I'm not gonna stop making fun of the whole season 3 release situation. It's happening, so let's make the most of it and laugh at it a little
Earth
bit.
Earth is the only planet we know of where life exists.
That's true.
And here it does so in abundance.
Show us.
Is less than 6% of the Earth's surface, but it's home to half of all the plants and animals on land.
That's impressive.
Jungles have just the right amount of light, water, and nutrients.
I wonder if they have any woodsmen in the jungle, like the jungle men. They're exactly like the woodsmen, but they're just wearing.
Should be easy.
You know, like panties that look like a tiger's fur, like Mowgli.
These forests in Madagascar are its home.
So there's a monkey jumping,
but to survive,
but it's not a monkey.
It has to face one major challenge.
It's a deceptive monkey. Oh, it's cute. I have to confirm that.
Paradise is crowded.
There's a frog. Oh my god, is this the Frogmas episode?
Every niche.
I'm
and
interested
at
now.
Time, a staggering variety of species and countless
a chameleon that really looks like Mr. C. Oh my god, there's a snake that looks like
every
a leaf. That was really impressive. That should become a character of season 4 of Twin Peaks. Laura! She's. In every episode, there's a little Laura just hiding in nature, waiting for us to discover her and bring her back home. Which is the jungle in this case. So where's Judy?
Jungles are complex places. Tangled, three-dimensional worlds created by lush tropical vegetation.
Yeah, we know that.
90% of the animals here spend their whole lives up in the trees.
I didn't know that.
And each of them has to find its own way of getting around.
Oh, so that's a true monkey.
30 meters above the ground,
it's like a giant monkey. It's got really long limbs. It's the fireman.
They travel in family groups and find everything they need in the top story of the jungle. Up here isn't a place for the faint-hearted.
Well, I don't think there is any place like that, according to your TV show. Just saying. Oh, a baby monkey.
But imagine having to learn these skills as
high. He seems so blasé. He's just like, another day in the jungle. I wish I was
1/3 of spider monkeys.
A fish. That's exactly what the baby monkey is thinking. It's really tiny.
This youngster is only a few months old.
Oh.
Her future depends on her ability to climb. Playing on a practice tree with her older brother and sister, she's already
a practice tree. How can you tell the practice ones from the real ones?
Under her father's close watch.
Not really, he's like asleep. That's a really bad parent.
She's keen to join in the game, but she's the youngest, and as is the way of things, she's not always welcome.
What?
So she chooses her own place.
I don't really like monkeys, but this one is cute. The baby one is cute.
Is for more advanced climbers.
Oh, it's like a training tree.
Enthusiasm? Certainly.
Are there any babies in Twin Peaks? Oh, there was that little kid. It didn't end very well for him.
Meanwhile, some of her family have moved on to look for a new patch of fresh food.
Okay.
The top of the canopy.
They don't have R&R. That's now been confirmed.
And the temptation to join the others is irresistible.
Peer pressure. Yeah, are we gonna witness another deadly accident or murder?
It's the first time she's been in
a This is Sunny Jim.
On her own.
And this is Sunny Jim. And his gym set. There's nothing else to say about this. It is clearly what is going on right now.
As she climbs still higher, the branches get thinner. And
careful. You don't want to become paraplegic when you're like 4 months old. Oh. Yeah, just keep filming, David. Don't help the monkey.
Her tail has caught her. But now she's stuck in midair. Unable to reach any other branch.
Oh, silly. Really bad parenting again. Sarah Palmer would like this. Oh.
Father, however, was watching.
Oh, thank you, Ray Wise.
Strong enough to form a bridge with his body so that she can climb to safety.
Well, that's a whole new Leland right there in front of us, redeeming himself for raping and murdering his daughter. That's very taboo, even in the monkey world. Okay, enough of the monkeys. They're pretty sweet. Maybe I do like monkeys after all.
Here, up in the treetops.
A little lizard?
And
it seems like such a jerk.
Finding the right tree can mean a home for life.
Well, that's the American dream, right there in front of you in the jungle.
He's a Draco lizard. He's only the size of a pencil, and he eats ants.
He is agile, just like Dougie. That one time he went all kung fu on this.
One tree could provide him with all he will ever need.
Assassin.
A conveyor belt of food. It's a perfect place to settle down.
Reptiles are pretty stupid, but they're also a miracle of evolution.
Well,
so I think they win over us.
But there's already someone here.
There's someone here. It's in our house now.
This larger male is the tree's owner.
It's like his stepbrother or something. It has this thing now. It means I'm really angry. Oh my god. It's exactly like in Jurassic Park with that thing like which throws ink into that horrible guy's face. And then he's like, and he rolls down in the rain and he eventually dies. Oh god. Maybe it's like a beard and it's a woodsman and he's just like got a light and you know when
safety is a long
only has
way.
One match left. So he's not gonna give his matches to the other woodsman. I mean, why would he? So that's not gonna end well. I've never seen a reptile commit murder. Or anybody else, I must say. Oh god, it's flying. It's got wings, but it's not wings, it's just
only in the
a cape.
You find lizards that can soar like dragons.
It's a dragon again. So
you
many dragons
over 30 meters
in planet Earth.
A single leap. It's a very fast and efficient way to move through the jungle.
Yeah. Pretty impressive. I hope you guys are watching or will be watching Planet Earth.
Maybe
stunning.
This tree will have food and no resident owner.
I mean, as the seasons go, season 1 of Planet Earth, season 2, season 3, by the time we're at season 50, is there even going to be any nature left? I hope so.
Only 2% of the sun's rays reach the ground. So even the plants must battle for the light they need if they're to grow.
Oh my god, even vegetation is fighting for its life. Against all the competition.
300 years ago,
the
Sakura tree began its race for light. And
this plant is Marjorie Green.
The water and sunshine it needs
because it's green.
Giant.
The giant. Man, there are so many connections. Nobody else saw it.
It has succeeded in
but
what every tree must do to survive.
Clearly there's a relationship between Twin
Rise
Peaks and planet Earth. So
floor.
We're doing the right thing right now. The fact that we are discussing this is so meant to be.
And what is more, its success has given
the music, it's supposed to be telling us something grandiose.
Its branches now
we don't want to see plants though. We just don't want to do that. Move on.
These particular ferns, figs and orchids live only on the branches of other trees.
I know it's also part of the planet. Fair enough. Can you imagine though watching like 18 hours of
throughout the forest, this story is repeated
of
endless
that.
Times.
No, I can't. Unless it's directed by
as
David Lynch, maybe.
Jungles are
yeah,
home to
I would. I totally would.
Than anywhere else on Earth. And they, in turn, support a wealth of animals.
It's like the stock market. Oh, cute.
In Ecuador, the competition is at its most intense.
Yeah.
Here there are 100 species of hummingbirds alone.
They're so beautiful.
All fighting for nectar.
Fighting for nectar. That's not something you hear every day, is it? Oh, there's a butterfly. Oh.
One hummingbird has gone to great lengths to avoid conflict with other species.
Yeah. Explain further.
Swordbills are the only bird with a beak longer than their body.
Interesting.
And some flowers are too elongated for the other 99 species of hummingbirds here to feed from them.
They're flying and drinking at the same time. I'm not really good at walking and drinking at the same time. I mean, I can, but it's just not comfortable. Yeah, we can't. You win.
Where the sweet nectar is produced. It has found a solution.
Oh, the normal ones like seem like such losers now because they have a tiny beak. The other one is like, shh.
And as each long flower blooms, it gives the swordbill a fresh supply of food all to itself.
So, how are you enjoying your Blu-ray or your absence of Blu-ray? You don't need to tell me. You can keep that for yourself if you like. I'll respect that.
For a start, it's tricky to keep it clean.
Okay. Oh. It's exactly doing like what my cat does. Just rubbing its cheeks against the furniture.
Unlike the other hummers, swordbills can't reach their feathers with their beak.
Oh. True.
The only option, a good old scratch.
They're kind of like navels. Those dolphins with the, like the unicorn dolphins, they're like that.
It's a little unrefined, but a small price to pay for an exclusive food supply. Especially when feeding times are only too frequent.
Man, this is like the worst episode. It's got a lot of birds, which Special Agent Del Cooper doesn't appreciate that much. Monkeys,
jungles,
which are like,
the richest places on Earth because of one
and plants. David, surprise us.
They make their own weather. Every day,
it's beautiful.
Water rises from the surface of the leaves.
There's a lot of smoke. This is where Philip Jeffries lives.
It's as if the trees breathe out clouds.
Or like there's a huge teapot
finally,
in the jungle.
They burst.
It's slippery in here because it's raining now. It's like every drop of water is actually a whole shower. So they're like, shower, shower, shower. So that could help the little bird from earlier to get clean. Because I mean, he can get as much as 200 showers in a minute if he's in the right spot where it's getting really slippery. Yeah, bathe. I don't think there's any character in Twin Peaks that enjoys going to the swimming pool on the weekends. Is there? I'm just asking. No reason.
In some jungles, like here in Brazil, it rains so much that for part of the year, the trees are almost totally submerged.
Interesting.
The forest floor is 10 meters below the water's surface. This is a mysterious world, a place few people have ever explored.
My cat is coming to join us. She's like, I hate monkeys.
We have much to discover.
And I hate lizards.
For which this is home.
And birds. She does hate birds. She wants to kill them.
Some, you might never expect.
And yet, if she faced one, she would run away in fear. I think the next project that David Attenborough does should be about indoor cats. It would be really popular. A lot of crazy cat ladies out there. Are you freaking kidding me? There are dolphins swimming in the forest.
A newly identified species of river dolphin found nowhere else on Earth.
I can't really close my mouth right now. This is crazy. I am stunned.
In these black tangled waters, they have become almost totally blind. So they move slowly, carefully using their sonar.
Cat.
To
I tell you, she doesn't like YouTube at all. Oh god, I am so amazed by this. The whole episode is worth it just because of those dolphins.
What else might there be?
Jungle dolphins. Who thought about this? Nobody.
At the shallow margins of the flooded jungle, rivers flow through lush vegetation.
Yeah, don't go. Don't start talking about the plants again.
Yeah, food is so abundant, it supports giants.
Oh, they're cute. Oh god, what a surprise. Have I ever said that anything is cute on planet Earth?
Giant otters, the size of a man.
Size of a man? Which man?
Like, the rulers of these rivers.
The arm?
Cayman.
Or the giant?
They grow to 10 feet long and kill anything.
Those guys look so stupid. They're just like waiting for, I don't know what they're waiting for.
There are more artful hunters drawn here.
I don't think they know either.
Forest.
This is very Jurassic. Ooh, this is a big cat.
A jaguar.
Jaguar. I like how he said it. Yeah, now my cat, that's why my cat doesn't like this. She feels like she's body shamed by the jaguars. Yeah, it's my cat. She's your competition. Ooh. They're like the Cheetos. Cheetah, Cheetos. One of them has got to be related to Chantal. Was Chantal. She's so badass.
This river for 5 years. This is her place to hunt.
Yeah, typical cat. Wow, I totally want to go swimming there, except for the whole jaguar threat. She looks really nasty. She's just like, nobody's messing with me, man. I'm the bully here. She seems like a jerk. She has like a resting bitch face too.
Capybara.
That's unfair. Nature is not. It's not always fair. It's never fair, actually. I hope it doesn't eat a dolphin. If I see that jaguar take a bite of a dolphin from Brazil who lives in the jungle, I will start a campaign on social media to stop them from doing it.
She needs to get with a llamita if she's to pounce.
Oh no. I think there will be a crime committed in the jungle today. Oh, you failed, Chantal. This is like the Russian guy.
Not this time.
Oh, he's not Russian, he's Polish. But it's not true because he was badass. And he killed Chantal, so I don't think that.
She's not the only
I don't know how it's called, that thing that you're probably not seeing because you're watching me instead of watching planet Earth. So you're cheating. Oh. Okay, good, she's not eating it. So between the caiman and the jaguar, who wins? Who wins the fight? Those things are too adorable. It's not a thing, it's an animal. I shouldn't objectify it. Uh-oh. Murder. She wrote. That jaguar is useless.
Weighing over 130 kilos, it's hard to be stealthy.
Yeah. Eating Cheetos all the time is not good for you, Chantal. Although you're still looking very good. Not the plants. If he's gonna just jump on a tree, or she, if Chantal is gonna jump on a tree and just take a bite of a giant leaf, I will be speechless. I don't want to see blood. Please don't show me blood. But I'll be drinking my Bloody Mary though. Oh, I have my answer now between the fake crocodile and the fake cheetah. It is clearly Chantal that wins over. And you know, the caiman is the representation of Mr. C's like crocodile skin boots. Clearly. This is the character that this reptile would be in Twin Peaks. Or maybe a purse. I'm sure Mr. C has a purse. Of course he wears a man purse. Of course he does. He doesn't need it. He doesn't need a man purse. He just wants a man purse. I'm glad we discussed that. Oh, is that Laura again?
Living in the dense understory of the jungle come in all shapes and sizes.
Oh my
god.
Is this an owl?
How to tell what is a plant and what is prey? This is a game
I don't know, just
hide and seek.
Eat everything and you'll find out. Oh, that's an insect that looks like a tiny green leaf. Yeah. She's like, what are you doing? Just come to bed with me. My cat is just, I don't know. She's very demanding. She's high maintenance. Okay, so there's a bunch of insects that look like they are not insects.
The long contest between predator and prey has produced mimicry of astounding accuracy.
Quite. What are you showing us? It's something's gonna move. We're gonna think it's a plant. Oh, that looks like some type of lizard. Yep, it's a chameleon, I guess.
A leaf-tailed gecko.
A gecko.
Masquerading as lichen.
Ooh. It looks like its cousin with the frog moth. Or the mug froth, if you're kind of dyslexic. It's pretty creepy.
Some animals take camouflage a stage further still.
Interesting, we're intrigued already.
And these streams in Costa Rica are home to one of the most remarkable.
What is it? Is it gonna be the little snake? Oh, it's the tiniest frog ever.
A glass frog.
It's like this big. It seems pretty gooey. You can see through it.
And tiny.
Yeah.
No bigger than your fingernail.
Oh.
And almost entirely transparent. As he needs to be.
I'm
almost
impressed.
Everything that walks past here could eat him. Even a cricket.
Crikey.
His best chance is to stay absolutely still and trust that the cricket looks right through him.
Oh god, it looks so stupid. I love it. Oh god, it looks so ridiculous. It's perfect. This could be a funny pet, although I would pet it.
And that's just as well.
Come on, frog moth.
Because he is a father. And he's guarding some very precious eggs.
My cat is really offended, but she doesn't understand.
Females, one after the other, have visited him and entrusted him with their offspring.
Oh god.
Some are now almost ready to hatch.
Oh god. It's so disgusting. It's like all these eggs they can see through, and there's like a little larva in it that's like
barely a day old.
It's fascinating. Ooh, it's gross though. I'm a faint-hearted person. Victory.
This wasp is a specialist.
The cat is here.
Ooh.
Oh god, it's really disgusting.
It's noticed the wriggling tadpoles at the bottom of the leaf.
Don't eat the unborn babies. That's really, that's not proper etiquette.
You mustn't move. The youngest eggs are the most vulnerable, and he can't guard them all.
That bee is just disgusting. Or the wasp, I guess. You have no taste. Oh, she just like breakfast. That's Judy for sure. This is the Judy of the jungle.
But these tadpoles are not as helpless as they might appear.
Oh, it's super gooey. Oh. Oh god. It just, the baby thing just jumped out of it. Gooey egg,
and
it moved like I can't describe this. It just looks like snot that's alive, running free, saving its life. I guess it's a touching lesson taught from nature.
However, are still too young to hatch. And now the wasps know they're there.
What? It's like they didn't know before?
Looks very like
they were eating it.
Cluster of eggs.
Come on, frog.
And that seems to confuse the wasps.
That's not good. Oh yeah, kick it. Oh, it's kicking it, all right. It's kicking it good. Ooh, gooey, gooey alert. Gooey Jones. This is Gooey Jones. I forgot to introduce Dougie, but you know him. And you know Fred Savage, my pretend son. And this is my cat, Anne Frank, because she's a rescue cat, and she likes to hide. That seems like a good reason to name her like this when I got her. Don't. Ooh, ooh. What an idiot. The frog just sort of stepped over its own babies.
He's managed to save most of his young.
Yeah, except like the three others he just stepped on.
But... he'll have to remain on guard for another 2 weeks.
Aww.
But in the jungle,
2 weeks, just like in Total Recall.
Can count as a success.
Got a light.
Flying insects begin to glow as they search for mates.
These look like UFOs.
Light plants thrive in the darkness of the forest floor.
Whoa.
They're hidden.
It's like coral.
Develop the incredible structures with which they reproduce.
How long did it take? Is this like fast forward?
Microscopic spores that drift invisibly away.
Wow. This
many
is
have fruiting bodies that reach upwards.
Those growing things. It looks exactly like Judy's eggs, if I can say that. Like when Bob was born out of that thing she throws up. This is it. So Bob is actually a mushroom, more or less. Yeah, he's...
why fungi light up has remained a mystery.
Kind of like a rotten parasite. So it could be some type of mushroom from space.
Until now.
It's a flute
scientists
moment.
Studying
like,
the brightest fungi in the world, think they may have an answer. Like a beacon, the light attracts insects.
It's very green, just like him. That's a very ordinary insect. It doesn't belong in this TV show. God, are the Smurfs going to just arrive there alongside Candy, Sandy, and Mandy doing like the thing? I think it might happen. But I'm not sure.
But he doesn't get the reception he was expecting.
Oh my God, it's all about Wi-Fi.
Confused, he starts searching for a female, and that helps the fungus. By the time he gives up, he's covered in the fungus's spores. And as he continues his quest for a female, he carries these spores to other parts of the forest.
Spreading
and there
it
are even
like
stranger things glowing in the jungle night.
Whoa.
These are the multicolored lights
caterpillars
of a railroad worm. It's not really a worm, but a poisonous caterpillar-like beetle.
Seems like a jerk.
Warn other creatures to keep out of its way.
Got a light. This one has got many lights.
It's hunting the millipedes.
That's almost like being a cannibal. He's really into crawling things that look like him, but without
when it
colors.
It switches off its yellow lights.
He looks like a Vuarnet t-shirt from 1991 with splashy fluo pink and green. It's really gross because you're seeing insects up close and nobody wants to do that. Insects are better from far away.
Is virtually invisible.
Jeez, man, this is like, well, this is like Blue Velvet.
That is the end of the millipede.
Okay, then, let's go back to interesting animals. It's beautiful. I want to see the dolphins again.
Competition in the jungles forces animals to specialize in every aspect of their life.
Earlier I said Mabel, I think I meant Narval. I'm pretty convinced of that.
Produced some of the most beautiful and elaborate displays on the planet.
This is a nice bird.
A male red bird of paradise, competing to attract a female by dancing. One has come to survey what's on offer.
I've never seen that before. It's got antennas on its butt. They're beautiful. They're like Dougie. Oh, Dougie and Jade. Jade gave two rides. That's actually amazing. Little chicken.
She makes her choice.
Yeah? Who's your favorite? It's like the Bachelorette. Their dancing is awful. I love it. They're like, well, it's actually not at all this.
But now she doesn't seem quite so sure.
Oh yeah, your dancing was awful, bro. Give up. Abort, abort now. She's going.
No. Perhaps she's just a little too keen.
Yeah, that happens. It's sad though. Oh, he's hurt inside. His ego is hurt. Oh.
Maybe he'll have better luck tomorrow.
That bird just sort of threw up a cherry out of nowhere. This is where
red birds of paradise display in the
cherry pies go to die.
Other members of the family dance in the gloom of the forest floor.
Are you kidding me? This is like an IMAX movie on its feathers. What's with all these butt antennas?
He's lived most of his life alone.
Aww.
But now he's an adult and he too needs to attract a mate.
This is so stunning. It looks like the logo for Google is the exact same colors. Oh my god.
First, he tied his things up. Showing off in this jumble of leaves wouldn't
be. That's like a freak, like an OCD.
And his beauty will stand out better against a plain background.
You can tell he didn't socialize very much when he was a kid. He doesn't get it.
He doesn't want bright leaves to divert a visitor's attention. They all need to go.
This guy is a control freak. I wouldn't advise any woman to date him. Unless she's even worse, then she'll like him. He's like competing against leaves. That shows a very low self-esteem.
A central pole and a little patch of light. It's perfect.
Is it? Okay.
And now he must hope a female hears his call.
I like him. He's a little bit clumsy and
he can wait here for weeks.
Misadapted. It sounds like a little dog from far away. Ooh, at last a female? If some guy says that in the street, I'll just cross the street and walk really fast.
But for the female to see him at his best, he needs her to perch directly above his sage.
What a vain loser.
Under the light.
Aww.
This might be his.
He's a star. He's a loser, but he's also like, he's Hollywood material. He's like Tom Jones.
Now, when she's looking directly down on him, he reveals a display for her eyes only.
Peep show. Again, it's like Jurassic Park. He did like, and then it was like green like this. Oh my god, it's like alien green. This guy is like Cirque du Soleil. All alone. He's more interesting than Cirque du Soleil, and he's less expensive too. Ooh, bird sex. Ooh, that was fast.
Each animal must find its own way of surviving the competition of the jungle.
What do you want now?
This crowded world is so full of invention that almost all kinds of animals on land can trace their origins back here.
Okay.
Including us.
Yeah, so we come from
forests in Madagascar.
We come from Madagascar.
Cousins. This female entry has fought to keep this particular patch of forest
cute
for herself and her family.
It's Laura again. Maybe it's actually like Sarah Palmer when she's wailing. Sarah is a pretty hairy lady, I gotta say. Oh, it's touching with its bright yellow eyes. I am mesmerized. Oh, there's a baby.
And the billions of animals with whom they share their home. The jungle is a sanctuary.
Oh god, they're too cute. I like those guys. This is like the monkey of the year. Because it's not a monkey. It's like a super monkey.
The head of this family was born, 10,000 square kilometers of the rainforest have been destroyed in Madagascar alone.
Yeah, not a good idea.
Half the entry families that once lived there. The local people say the Indras are our brothers, and their song is a call to remind us that we too once depended on the jungle.
It's hugging a tree, like it's its best friend. They seem like very wise creatures, and I'm not even kidding.
Place of wonder and magic.
Magic. That's a magician between two worlds.
Something, surely. worth protecting.
Yeah, I agree. I want to protect those. It's gonna be like, I'll be like Audrey with the weasels.
Next time, a land of extremes that pushes
deserts. Oh my god, we're gonna see Scorpios.
Animals have extraordinary
like scorpions and
hostile conditions.
Horses
epic survival stories on
and
Earth.
Giraffes. Well, hopefully it's gonna be, it's not gonna, they're not gonna discuss the sand for 34 minutes, but I'm sure we could have stuff to talk about while watching. So I guess we'll find out in a few days. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you've enjoyed our Bloody Mary session this time. Yeah, I never know how to end these things. I don't like goodbyes. So thank you so much for watching. Subscribe, let me know whatever you want to tell me. And if not, well, I salute you and I wish you good night. So bye.